Project with me this morning from 27 Companies, Ian Warland. Ian, morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
Doing well, Ian, thank you. Look, your recent RC drill program at Rover, give us a bit of a recap. How did it go?
Oh, it went really well. Yeah, we did around 2,000 metres of RC, testing four targets, gold targets on the Maynard Hills Greenstone Belt. We're really focusing on the Alara Shear Zone there, where we've already discovered shallow mineralisation at Harmonic and Creasy 1 gold prospects. The highlight of the program really was extending mineralisation at the Harmonic gold prospect. So we had some great broad intercepts of gold mineralisation from surface, you know, 17 metres at 1, including some higher grades there as well, 3 metres at 5. So at Harmonic, that was really the standout there, and it's still open to the south and to the north.
Are you still drilling at Rover?
Oh, we just finished that campaign, and we're now moving on with a more geochemical campaign just to the north of Harmonic. So Harmonic was recently discovered by a soil geochemistry about 12 months ago, and subsequent drilling, you know, has proven up some shallow mineralisation there. We've proved up around 200 metres of strike length, down to about 70 or 80 metres deep of gold mineralisation. There's still more work to do, but we want to look at the whole belt because we do have over 140 kilometres of greenstones to cover there. And so we've just recently completed a soil geochem program just to the north of Harmonic, about 10 k's north, along the Alara Shear Zone, covering a section of about 8 kilometres of that shear zone. So we're pretty excited about that area too, because that's got this a strong sort of ridge in that area that indicates that the shear is actually active between two major lithologies. And some historical soil sampling had found some anomalous gold. So we're following that up, and that should hopefully generate some drill targets for early new year.
And on the back of a recent site visit to Mount Dymer, you're looking to accelerate the work program there, Ian. What are the plans?
Yeah, so the plans are at Mount Dymer. So Mount Dymer is in the Marder Greenstone Belt. The Mount Dymer project we just recently acquired. It's about 200 kilometres south of Rover. So we're getting quite a commanding position now in the central Yilgarn. So we had a team go to our Mount Dymer mining lease. Now, Mount Dymer mining lease has an old open cut on it. The open cut took about 8,500 ounces out back in the mid-90s, and no one's really done any substantial work there from the mid-90s. So the team went out there. We did an aerial drone survey. You know, it's fantastic technology these days that can take down to 5 centimetre resolution on the ground. So we've mapped the open pit. We've also been able to map in drill collars from the old drilling in the 90s. And now we're taking all that data and we're putting that into our 3D models. And from that work is still ongoing. But, you know, our initial sort of look at that work is indicating that there's a southerly plunge to the gold mineralization under the pit that's still open. And there's some very interesting old historical gold intercepts there.
And you're looking at some options to generate some early cash flow out of this, are you?
Yeah, that's right, Andrew. So as part of the process, the team sampled an old tailings storage facility. So in the 90s, there was a gold plant there. They produced a tailings storage facility with around, we believe, 85 tonnes of material was milled and in that tailings dam. And so we decided to take some grab samples from surface, and we got a range of gold grades up to about an average of 0.4 grams per tonne in the tailings. So that's given us enough encouragement to go back. We want to go back and do some auger drilling and just see how the grade distribution is in the tailings, and then do some further work, metallurgy work, to see if we can recover that gold from the tailings. And that's certainly not our main game. You know, we just thought, well, there could be some low-hanging fruit. It could be early cash flow. But our main game is to confirm mineralisation under the pit and hopefully extend that mineralisation so we get some near-term resources.
And you've got the RC drill applications lodged now, have you?
That's right. So we've got the approvals already in with the government, with the regulators. So we should get those, you know, prior to the end of the year. We'll finalise our 3D model, and then we'll be out there as drilling as soon as possible. So I guess the strategy really there at Mount Dymer is potential near-term resources at the current mining lease, but we do have an exploration licence adjacent to that mining lease, which hopefully, you know, will give us some scale because it's quite underexplored. It's in a very prospective greenstone belt, so we'll be doing in tandem an exploration program over that exploration lease as well.
And so just to summarise, Ian, from what you've said during our conversation, as far as near-term news that we can expect from you, what shall that be?
Yeah, so near-term news, we at Rover Project, we'll be talking about the geochem results and the mapping results and generation of new gold targets. So we'll wait for those results to come in. And at Mount Dymer, we'll be compiling all this 3D information from our recent drone survey, coming up with our drill targets, announcing those drill targets and the approvals for drilling and hopefully some dates for drilling early in the new year.
Very good. Ian, good to catch up. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Andrew. It's always a pleasure.